Today we're going to be looking at 3D printed accessories for playing the Nintendo Switch with one hand. At the Controller Project, we help people with physical disabilities be able to play video games by doing 3D printed modifications to controllers. I've got a huge library of parts, but unfortunately, many of them are untested. So I'm doing this video series to test some of those parts to see if they're printable, if they work like they say, if the documentation is right, if there's any tips and tricks to putting them together, and to get the word out. Today, we're going to be checking out the single-hand gaming kits for the Nintendo Switch. It's a cool-looking kit, and right off the bat, I got to say, well, first of all, I've printed this one before, I know it works, but it looks good. It's got good documentation. There are images of it printed, so we know somebody's been able to print it. Let's get to it. Let's throw it into the slicer and let's see what we think. All right, let's pull this into Prusa Slicer. Auto-arrange it. Nothing here stands out, really. Your printer might have some hard times with these little tiny bits of ornamentation here. Like if you print with a raft or something, you might lose some detail there. My printer does not have a hard time with that. And you only need to print whichever side you're going to use. You can delete the rest. Everything else, I mean, it's already on the table or on the bed. It's already aligned properly. You can pretty much just slice this and print it. There's both the right-handed and left-handed versions. Here are the little button pressers, this little bit, and then this cap. Okay, so this is just a lanyard holder. So the lanyard holder goes in here, and then you glue it in place. And so you would put that on whichever one you want. It's totally optional. Then the way it works is that this piece, this little piece slides in here. And then it's kind of tight. I like to take a knife and scrape down the sides a bit. But you can see it goes in there. And then these little pins slide into here and you glue them in place. Like this. You place your Joy-Cons in there and then put this piece over it to hold it all in place. This does work technically. However, there is a weak point here. These pins, when glued in place, they're not great. I don't like to glue them in place. So what I actually like to do is drill through this and put a little bolt through there. Let me show you how that works. Okay, so this is the part that we're working with here. And I'm gonna use this bolt through it. So I've got a drill bit that is the proper size for this, and we'll just drill right through it. Then once you have that through, then you can feed your bolt through. I'm going to use some washers so that it doesn't catch on things. So let's see here, this one goes on top, stick that through there, another washer. And then through here. And then another washer. And then this. And the bolt, or the nut. Once you get that tightened down, you have this, and you can plop it in like that. And the bolt will hold much longer. It'll last much, much longer and be more resilient. If you were to redesign this part, to print in a single piece, with protrusions from the sides and then cap it off somehow. I think that would be a slightly more robust design, but this modification works. Let's put it together and see what it looks like all together. So I think this actually, it looks fantastic. It feels good in my hand. You know, I can't tell you how well you would be able to game with it, but I think it's a really elegant solution. As a bonus, this creator also makes an even simpler solution for one-handed gaming on the Switch, and that's this set. Now, while you're watching this print, I want to thank my Patreon supporters. Those people who support us help us out a lot. They pay for the materials that we use, the 3D printing filament. They pay for my time helping volunteers. We helped over 120 people be able to game last year. If you'd like to consider supporting us on Patreon, there's a link down below. These are just a simple piece of plastic that you can attach the controllers in a very, you know, various ways. So you can attach them like that, facing away from each other, and hold it like this. Sometimes simplest is best. I think this is fantastic. And then this one is at an angle. So you can do, you know, facing towards each other or facing away from each other again. And they just slide in like this. And so you can hold it with one hand. Really fantastic stuff, in my opinion. I think you did a great job. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for your support. Thank you for your thumbs up on this video. It really helps me out. Be sure to let me know in the comments down below if there are any specific files you want me to test. I'll see you on the next video.